Well, the best thing that was happening at that point was that we were all starting to get comfortable in each other's presence. We were all very relaxed. We're getting used to each other's company. And Brian started offering up musical suggestions, which was just wonderful. I mean, to be sitting in this room, literally collaborating with one of your heroes, was just, it's a event, it's a feeling, it's a situation I can't even describe. The ideas start flowing, people are writing musical ideas and notes, notation down on the paper. Just then, some stranger comes in the room, one of his many babysitter caretakers, taps him on the shoulder and whispers in his ear, Brian, it's time for your 2 o'clock nap. And Brian goes, well, thanks guys, it was a pleasure meeting you, I gotta get going, it's time for my nap, and I gotta get on with my day's events. And we'd literally been in the room for a mere 30 to 45 minutes. And Andy and I are looking at each other going, what? Well, we're just getting started here. What's going on? What do you mean you got to take your nap? And Don was goes, yeah, but I guess we're going to have to wrap it up and schedule another writing session soon. And don't ask me why. There were no additional writing sessions. Don was stopped returning our phone calls. And we never heard from Brian or his entourage again. And that's where it ended. That was our exciting but frighteningly brief experience with Brian Wilson. Cut to me looking for songs to do for this record. I've always loved the initial spark and genesis and main verse and chorus of this tune. So I decided to resurrect it because I didn't want it to be left on the cutting room floor, as they say, shriveling up on the shelf. I wanted to finish this idea. I believed in it. And I believed if I just messed with the arrangement and fleshed it out, I wrote a whole new bridge, wrote lyrics from the ground up, orchestrated the whole damn thing, took me forever. All the vocals just take a huge amount of time to write and perform. But I'm very, very happy with how this song came out. But the listener should know that it was originally written for a Beach Boy, basically. I mean, that's why it sounds, that's why it has those overtones, those very Beach Boy-inspired overtones. But that's the story behind that record. I mean, it's a story that I'd be proud to tell for Rolling Stone. should Rolling Stone want such an interview at some point? You heard it here first in Stu-Stu-Studio.